sign of your coming and of the end of the world. Now, it's not the end of the world. Praise the Lord, the world will never end. That's been a misconception. It's the end of the church age, because Christ is coming back to set up the kingdom for 1,000 years, Revelation 20, verse 4. So what it should say is the end of the church age to go into the age of the kingdom. How do I know that? Because Isaiah 45, 17, Ephesians 3, 21 says it's a world without end. Amen. That's plain enough to understand, isn't it? All right. So they came to Jesus and said, tell us, when shall all these things be? What shall be the sign of your coming? Jesus answered and said, take heed that no man deceive you, for many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. And you shall hear wars and rumors of wars. See not, that you be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation shall grind sin against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in diverse places. All these are the beginning of sorrows. Then shall they deliver you up. The afflicted shall kill you, and you shall be persecuted by all nations for my name's sake. Then shall many be offended, shall betray one, and shall hate one another. Many false prophets shall rise and shall deceive many. And because iniquity shall abound, sin. And because of all this sin, the love of many shall wax cold. They'll be slipping and doing everything and thinking it's all right. And the